Attorney General William Barr heading to El Salvador as the Trump administration looks to combat the notorious MS-13 gang. My next guest represents a district that has suffered at the hands of the notoriously brutal gang. Congressman Lee Zeldin on the House Foreign Affairs Committee joins us now. Congressman, good morning to you.
Good morning.
It is one of the most brutal gangs, one of the largest gangs on the planet. 8,000 to 10,000 members, one of the most violent gangs on Long Island. This is a problem for you and your district. 25 killings on Long Island between 2016 and 2018 alone. What can we do about this? How are we fighting this?
Since President Trump came into office, the Department of Justice, the administration, President Trump himself have had significantly greater focus on this issue, different levels of government working together. What we've seen over the course of these last couple of years with a big crackdown, taking out MS-13 leadership and others. It's not just the high-profile, brutal murders that make national news. It's the regular instances of drug trafficking and sex trafficking, the human trafficking that's taking place. It takes a very human toll on the victims. So fortunately, what we've seen with the heavier focus is a crackdown with the Eastern District of New York, the U.S. Attorney's Office, with the DOJ. There's more to be done, and it really requires, to a certain extent, when you're talking about a transnational gang, it's a transnational effort, and a lot of the money flow goes between countries. Where the DEA, the FBI need any additional tools, changes in law, we in Congress need to be providing the administration with the maximum support possible to prevent any further loss of life and any other further victims.
We'll see how that all goes, and we'll hear more from William Barr in that big interview, of course, with Bill Hemmer soon. Congressman, if I could transition to another trend that you are identifying in the House of Representatives, and that is anti-Semitism and rhetoric and acts that you have identified as a growing trend in Congress. What are you planning to do about that?
Just yesterday, House Republicans filed what's called a discharge petition. If 218 members of the House of Representatives signs this discharge petition, we'll have a vote on anti-BDS legislation. BDS is the Boycott, Divestment, and Sanctions Movement. Unfortunately, the founder of BDS was blatantly anti-Semitic with all sorts of horrible quotes to back that up. We have Jewish students on college campuses all across America being targeted with blatant anti-Semitism in the name of BDS. We need to send a strong statement as a body that we stand against all this anti-Semitism, all the anti-Israel hate. Israel is our greatest ally in the Middle East, and it's a relationship that we should be strengthening, not weakening. But we also, beyond making a statement, need to also do something about it, pass legislation with teeth. So the House Republicans, we filed it yesterday. I would encourage any of my Democratic colleagues, many whom we know support the legislation itself, to sign this discharge petition to force a vote. The Senate has already passed this bill. And one other thing that I would point out is what we've seen over the course of this week is that Nancy Pelosi, Speaker Pelosi, is actually going in the wrong direction, where she's now attacking Republicans, calling on us to apologize to these people who are pushing it.
So specifically, you are talking about this instance with a recent member of Congress making comments about the Holocaust. Republicans called on Nancy Pelosi to condemn those remarks. She instead said that Republicans were twisting her words and that it was a smear campaign. Finally, your thoughts on that, and do you fear that you're further dividing Congress with this move?
Well, I will tell you, first off, we should be uniting Congress in the effort to strengthen our relationship with our greatest ally. We should be uniting Congress to stand unequivocally, forcefully in condemning anti-Semitism, whether it's in American politics, the halls of Congress, or college campuses. But what should be noted with that interview with my colleague Rashida Tlaib last Friday is that she was being asked about her support for a one-state solution. Her solution is one that removes Jews from power in their own country,
right,
in Israel.
And
answering that.
And we heard a lot about that, and I know that you've been very active on this issue. We'll see where it all goes, Congressman. We appreciate your time this morning, and we'd like to have you back. Thank you.
Thank you, Sandra.